Was einer allein nicht schafft, das schaffen viele.
Das ist der Kern unserer genossenschaftlichen Idee.
Ganz einfach und ganz logisch. Und deswegen sind allein in Deutschland 20 Millionen Menschen Mitglied einer Genossenschaft.
In Europa sind es 140 Millionen. Und weltweit sind sogar 800 Millionen Menschen von der genossenschaftlichen Idee überzeugt. Kein Wunder. Genossenschaften sind für alle ein Gewinn. Wir sind keine Aktiengesellschaft, für die der Profit alles ist. Wir Genossenschaften sind nur unseren Mitgliedern verpflichtet. Und nur unsere Mitglieder bestimmen, wo es lang geht. Jeder mit einer Stimme. Ganz demokratisch.
In Germany, modern cooperatives can already look back on a history of over 160 years. Along with the first pioneers, it was mainly two men who realized their vision through impressive perseverance in the face of resistance and reluctance. Independently of each other, it was Hermann Schulze Delitzsch in what is now Saxony and Friedrich Wilhelm Raiffeisen in today's state of Rhineland-Palatinate who laid the crucial foundations for cooperative activities in the middle of the 19th century. It was a time when increasing rural to urban migration following the emancipation from serfdom and industrialization led to social unrest. Livelihoods were endangered. It was a fight for survival. The combination of these social ills led to a crucial step: helping people to help themselves.
Hermann Schulze Delitzsch rief 1850 aus Mangel an Kapital unter den kleinen Gewerbetreibenden den Delitzscher Vorschussverein ins Leben und gab damit die Chance für eine berufliche Neuorientierung.
Joint ventures of this kind had existed since the Middle Ages, but Hermann Schulze Delitzsch made more of it.
Das Neue ist nun, dass das auf eine theoretische Basis gestellt wird, dass hier gesetzliche Grundlagen geschaffen werden, dass das letztendlich zur Unternehmensform wird.
During the same period, much like Schulze Delitzsch in the city, Raiffeisen established regional associations of villages in the country.
Mich fasziniert die Verantwortung, die er wahrgenommen hat für jeden einzelnen Menschen. Er wollte nicht das System umstellen, sondern Raiffeisen hat sich für jeden einzelnen Menschen in seinem christlichen Menschenbild fundiert gekümmert und wollte dort helfen, wo Not ist. Und das ist ihm beispielhaft gelungen.
His efforts, such as the Flammersfeld Benevolent Society for the support of fundless farmers, led to viable associations. Nowadays, the German Hermann Schulze Delitzsch Society and the Friedrich Wilhelm Raiffeisen Society preserve and commemorate the cultural and political legacy of the two founding fathers of the cooperative. With forums, museums, and image campaigns, they contribute significantly to the preservation and promotion of the cooperative principle. Today, the modern cooperative model has taken root in all areas of society, even among the youngest. School cooperatives offer members their first insights into concrete economic, environmental, and social concerns. They are treated just like real cooperatives. The goal, moral values such as personal initiative and team spirit can foster entrepreneurial thinking and action. An optimal basis for orientation in their future lives. Creating something together, achieving goals, feeling secure. Likewise, within your own four walls. The poor housing conditions of the late 19th century provided the impetus for the emergence and development of housing cooperatives. Since then, they ensure stable rental conditions without speculation and protect tenants from exploitation and displacement. Housing cooperatives do not endeavor to make a profit. They decide over property use and surpluses on an equal basis. Cooperatives such as these enable economic livelihoods as well as social and cultural projects that would not be feasible under other circumstances. Cooperative associations are not bound to political or religious affiliations and are thus represented in almost all areas of daily life. And when it comes to energy, cooperatives have now stepped into the future. They make a significant contribution to increasing societal motivation toward an energy revolution. Especially where ambitious individual initiatives require investment, the cooperative idea is particularly present.
Die meisten Menschen kennen das ja von D'Artagnan. Einer für alle, alle für einen. Aber für uns hier ist das wirklich anders. Wir kennen das von Friedrich Wilhelm Raiffeisen. Und ich glaube, letztendlich, das ist wirklich der Grund. Wir fragen die Menschen hier und sagen, wir haben die und die Projektidee. Wir wollen den Strom für uns hier selber machen und für andere erneuerbare Energien. Der Zuspruch, ich kann es nur so erklären. Es ist wirklich so, dass die Menschen dann sagen, genau, das schaffen wir.
Through commitment and the willingness to compromise, a common goal is realized. The cultural core of the cooperative idea is the possibility of organizing social interests. Therefore, it's not only in Germany that the cooperative concept plays a major role. Many countries around the world have successfully adopted cooperative principles. With adapted legal frameworks, they use the cooperative idea to drive development in their own countries. In order to draw attention to the global importance of cooperatives, the UN declared 2012 to be the International Year of Cooperatives. Particularly in emerging and developing countries, cooperative institutions offer disadvantaged people economic and social support, providing opportunities for emancipation. The cultural form of organizing shared interests in cooperatives is highly important for everyday life to this day, in Germany and worldwide. It ranges from wind energy to coffee plantations, from the first experiences in school cooperatives through to support in old age at a retirement home. With the basic principles of self-help, self-management and self-responsibility, cooperatives bring social and economic development into harmony like hardly any other form of cultural expression. They enable the organization of interests, prevent exclusion and exploitation, and promote stability, security, and continuity. Cooperative methods have proven to be immensely adaptable to current challenges. In this way, cooperatives also support the viability and innovative capacity of communities. Cooperative practice is about concrete, tangible commitment. The cohesion exemplified by cooperatives with their large memberships is a positive influence on society. A cooperative is a community where everyone is a winner. True to the motto, what cannot be achieved by one person alone can be achieved by many.